feeling good. Well, I haven't had time to get injured or fatigued yet, so. Weather is amazing. Loving this. We're at 4 kilometers, 195 meters ascent so far. So it's been a lot of uphills. Going slow, giving the body some time to warm up. Feeling good though, having fun. All right, so we are 10 kilometers in. We have almost 400 meters accumulated ascent. I was thinking that I would start eating at this point. I have some fresh Iranian dates, but I had a fresh orange juice this morning, so I will not start eating just yet. All right, all downhill, flat roads, killing my knees. We're at 15 kilometers or a bit more. I'm starting to eat now. One fresh Iranian date per kilometer. Delicious. Just past the first water and food station, the start of the 31 kilometer, so that's how far we have left. I am grabbing another date. Very sweet. And since I had that orange juice this morning, I will probably not need to eat all the dates. It might actually just make it harder. A lot of sugar, and that demands water. So I don't want to eat. I don't want to eat more than necessary. Walking now, long and kind of steep uphill. Actually kind of 3 kilometers uphill or something, I think. Kind of bad. Anyways, I refilled the water bladder and thinned out the cucumber, celery, lemon juice that I had with even more water. So it's actually maybe a bit easier to get down. I hope it will also be absorbed as well. So the last hill was 200 meters ascent, and that isn't much more uphill now, but there is some. Still have a couple, maybe 300 meters climbing, but that will be spread out over about 20 kilometers, a bit less, so it's not much at all. Unfortunately, most of the trails are like this. No trails at all, actually a gravel road. But it's beautiful. And the weather is amazing. I'm on the best stretch of the whole course now. This is so much more fun running. And better for my body and the knees. The rougher the trails, the more people I pass. On the road, I can't run so hard. It's like too bad for my knees. But on the trails like this, I can just have more fun and go a bit harder. And this is where I also catch up with the most people compared to when I'm running on the road. Beautiful. Twenty-two kilometers in. Time to eat a date. Bit of a line forming here, but I will see if I can pass. Tack, tack. So I'm just over 22 and a half kilometers in. My body is now well activated and feeling comfortable and really good. And on these rougher trails, my knees hurt much less and seems to be tougher for a lot of people, so I am passing a lot of people. This is the best section of this race, hands down. Heart rate is up a bit. Of course, I'm running a bit harder, faster. So even though the rough trails are where I like it most and where I can run harder, those kilometers are actually slower because the trail is so much more demanding and snaking left right all the time. We had a lot of snow late in the winter, but then the snow melted quickly, so it's actually really dry. More dry than last year and the year before. I will not eat dates all the time, take it easy with the dates, and just focus on hydrating instead. That will be much more important. I will do more drinking and more refilling at the water and food stations, and less munching on dates. I kind of like these flat trails because they're fast and fun, but they're not as fun as the rough technical trails, and they're definitely not as good for my body, and they don't give nearly as much training in terms of nervous system, agility, coordination, eye, mind, nervous system, muscle, body, connection. Hey, nice view. Right at 27 kilometers, second to last food and water station. So I just refilled my water bladder. So I haven't trained this winter, only trained for a few weeks, maybe 4 weeks, with a little bit of strength training and a little bit of running now before the race. Taking it a bit easy, walking the uphills and trying to save my legs a bit, but we'll see how it feels towards the end. Almost at 30 kilometers now. Feeling pretty good. I'm starting to feel a bit like strain in the top front of my right thigh, but it's not that bad. Pretty steep uphill here, so walking a bit. Feeling pretty good. Trying to drink. I haven't peed much in the last bit. Starting to be a bit dehydrated maybe. I'm not eating as much because that would worsen the dehydration situation. All right. Kilometers. Some quite pretty nature here. It's nice along this river. Trails are a bit up and down. Not super technical, but a bit. It's nice. A guy just took a nosedive right in front of us. Scraped up his knees, shoulder, and our forehead. And face a bit, his glasses seemed okay though, only like skin damage, but still, yeah, have to be careful. So there was a photographer, and I smiled and gave my thumbs up as usual, but then everybody up on the balcony was sharing. I was like, yeah, this is awesome. And then I saw these newlyweds that they apparently were sharing for. Well, I mean, take what you can get, right? It's all road now. Me no like so much. Cardio wise, I'm feeling pretty good. Much better than I thought I would after a whole winter, the whole fall and winter without training. And my legs are actually doing also better than I thought they would. They are feeling heavy, so I'm walking up hills. Just past the 40 kilometer water station, got showered a bit and refilled my water bladder, but now the cucumber, celery, lemon juice has been, well, basically completely thinned out. It's basically only water now, so I notice it's a bit more like hard on the stomach. All right, so it's now the day after. I didn't have time to record more yesterday because I was so busy just eating and taking care of myself after the run. And now we're going to the vegetarian festival here in Oslo. It's actually vegan. They don't have much raw foods, or well, maybe some foods that are raw but not actually raw, and definitely not super healthy compared to real fruits and greens like the smoothie here. I usually don't drink these big smoothies in the morning with greens in them, but since I ran so much yesterday, and I just figure I do this, and then I can go to the festival and just bring some water and, you know, not stress so much about getting enough calories in for the recovery and healing. Some were wondering about the shoes I was wearing. They are really like thick cushioning, and they look kind of super fat in a picture I posted. They are really thick. They have the same kind of outer sole as these, so pretty good grip for the trails, but since there are so many roads, gravel and asphalt roads in this race, I chose a shoe that has a higher stack height and more cushioning to just go easier on my knees. It gives less impact. I still run with a proper like 4 foot landing, and it definitely works with those thicker shoes, but I do prefer the thinner ones, even thinner than this too, to get a more of a feel of the ground. And for socks, I always use Injinji. These are great. I use the Cool Max. They are vegan. It's a synthetic sock, not the Wool Max, of course. I don't particularly want to support torturing sheep for their merino wool. No, these Cool Max in Injinji socks, they have them in thinner and thicker varieties. These are the no-show, very low sock, and they have a bit higher sock, and the even higher ones that go really up the leg.
And I use these for running. I use them for everyday life. I use them at work all the time. They felt super weird in the beginning because of the toes. But when I got used to it, I just stopped wearing any other socks. So, and these are absolutely amazing when it comes to preventing blisters and keeping your feet good during the run. So this is how my feet look like day after. There is nothing wrong, no blisters, nothing. And they looked like that yesterday. So it's absolutely amazing how these socks have helped me. After the run yesterday, I just lie down a bit. I ate some grapes and had some smoothie and took some ice cold baths and went into a sauna, really a hot sauna, and just in and out, cold bath, hot sauna, cold bath, hot sauna. It's super nice, get you all cleaned up and good right after the run. It's super comfortable and it's really good for the body. Actually, I think it helps with the recovery too, to do the alternating hot and cold. So, and also I really enjoy it. I did have some pains, some muscles, the thighs, quads, mainly the right quad, the top of it. I still feel it a little bit, but other than that, my legs are totally good. I might get some DOMS coming in here later, I don't know, but I feel pretty good. My knees were hurting a bit tender, but nothing bad. The worst was the heat. It was more than 30 degrees Celsius, I think like 30, 32. And to stay out and active in that heat for so long, you really need a lot of fluid. So I tried to drink a lot. Towards the end, my juice that I had in my hydration bladder got thinned out so much because I refilled with water, and then it got more and more difficult to get the water down because is really not the same as some good juice from non-sweet fruits and vegetables. So that was it for this run. Now you go raw, stay raw, and keep on keeping on. Cheers!